اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم کلمہ طیبہ بلیف ان دی ہیئر آفٹر حدیث آف دا پروفٹ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم ابن عباس رضی اللہ عنہما نریٹس دیٹ ابو بکر رضی اللہ عنہ سیڈ او رسول اللہ انڈیڈ یو ہیو ایجڈ ہی ریپلائڈ دا سورہ ہود سورہ واقعہ سورہ مرسلات سورہ اما یتساءلون اینڈ اذ الشمس کبرت ہیو ایجڈ می ترمذی خالد ابن عمیر الادوی رضی اللہ عنہ نریٹس دیٹ عتبہ ابن غضوان رضی اللہ عنہ ان اے سرمن آفٹر گلوریفائنگ اینڈ پریزنگ اللہ سیڈ ٹو اس انڈاؤٹڈلی دا ورلڈ ہیز اناؤنسڈ اٹس ٹرمینیشن اینڈ ہیز ٹرن آؤٹ اٹس ہیلز ان اے ہیسٹی فلائٹ اینڈ واٹ از لیفٹ آر بٹ اے فیو ڈراپس لائک دا ریزیڈیول ڈراپس ان اے بول وچ دا ڈرنکر سکس آؤٹ اینڈ انڈیڈ یو ول آل be transferred at death from the world to a never-ending abode. So depart with the best deeds with you. For verily, it has been mentioned to us that when a stone is cast from the edge of hell, it continues to fall for 70 years but will not reach its depth. And by Allah, hell will be filled with men and jinn. So does this surprise you? And it has been mentioned to us that expanse between the two panels of the door of paradise is a journey of 40 years. Yet a day will come when the expanse will be packed due to the large crowds of people. And verily, I have seen that time when I was the seventh among seven Sahaba with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We had nothing to eat but leaves of tree until corners of our mouths became festered with ulcers. I managed to acquire a piece of broadcloth which I divided between myself and Saad bin Malik. So I wore it to cover my lower half and Saad ibn Malik wore the other piece. But today, each of us is an Amir, meaning the governor of a city from amongst the great cities. And verily, I seek refuge in Allah that I should ever consider myself great, whereas I am regarded low by Allah. And verily, never is there a prophethood and its ways except that gradually it goes into oblivion until worldly kingdom takes its place. So in the near future, you will realize and have the experience of other governors. Muslim. Note, the characteristics of prophetic ways is that justice is established and people develop an indifference to this world and the love of the hereafter prevails. Whereas in worldly kingdoms, these characteristics are not usually found. Takmala Fathul Mulhim. Aisha radiallahu anha narrates that whenever it was her turn for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to spend the night, he would go out at the end of the night to Baqi, the graveyard, and say, "Peace be upon you, O dwellers of the abode of believers, the tomorrow which you were being promised about has reached you and its appointed time. And Allah willing, we shall be joining you. O Allah, forgive the dwellers of Baqi." Muslim. Mustawrid bin Shaddad radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "By Allah, this world compared to the hereafter is like one of you dipping his finger in the ocean and then observing the quantity of water on it." Muslim. Shaddad bin Aus radiallahu anhu narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "He is wise and shrewd who takes account of himself and prepares for what is after death. And he is weak and incapable who follows his desires and yet pins high hopes on Allah's mercy." Tirmidhi. Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhuma narrates that I came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Being the 10th one of 10 sahabat, a man of the Ansar stood up and said, "O Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who is the wisest and the most resolute amongst people?" He replied, "He who remembers death the most and prepares most diligently for death before it overtakes him. Undoubtedly, these are the wisest. They have acquired the nobility of this world and the dignity of the hereafter." Ibn Majah, Tabrani, Majma'ul Dhabaid. Abdullah radiallahu anhu narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam traced a square and traced a line in the middle protruding out of its borders and traced smaller lines up to the line that was in the middle, and then he said, "This middle line is man, and this square is death surrounding him, decreed lifespan, and the line protruding out of the square shows his hopes." And these smaller lines are the incidents to take place. If one incident misses him, he is mangled by the other. And if it misses him, he is mangled by yet another. Bukhari. Mahmud ibn al-Labid radiallahu anhu narrates that indeed Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "There are two things that the son of Adam dislikes. Death, although death is better for a believer than trials, which endanger his faith, and scarcity of worldly belongings. And this scarcity of worldly belongings results in less reckoning on the day of judgment." Musnad Ahmad. Abu Salma radiallahu anhu narrates, "I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying, 'He who meets Allah testifying that none is worthy of worship but Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and believes in resurrection and in reckoning, enters paradise.'" Al-Bidayah wa Nihaya. Umm Darda radiallahu anhu narrates, "I inquired from Abu Darda, 'Why do you not go and seek for your guests that men usually seek, like fine food and drink for their guests?' So he replied, 'I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, verily, before you is a very difficult pass. The heavily burdened shall not cross through it with ease. So I desire to keep myself light for that passage.'" Baqi. Note: "Men seek fine food and drink" means that his wife wanted him to take out time and effort to earn, if not for his family, then at least for the sake of his guests. Hani Rahimahullah, the freed slave of Usman radiallahu anhu, narrates that when Usman stood by the grave, he would weep until his tears would wet his beard. So he was asked, "When paradise and hell are mentioned, you do not weep, but why do you weep at the sight of the grave?" So he replied, "Indeed, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, 'Verily, the grave is the first stage among the stages of the hereafter. If one is saved from the punishment of it, then what is to follow will be easier. And if one does not find safety from it, then what is to follow shall be more severe than it.' And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, 'I have not seen a sight more horrifying than the punishment of the grave.'" Tirmidhi. Usman bin Affan radiallahu anhu narrates that when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to finish the burial of the dead, he would stay at his grave and say, "Seek forgiveness for your brother and beg steadfastness for him, as indeed he is now being questioned." Abu Dawud. Abu Thayyid radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, while entering his masjid, saw some persons laughing in a manner that their teeth were visible. He said, "Behold, if you frequently remember the destroyer of pleasures, that is death, it will distract you from what I am seeing, your excessive laughing. So remember frequently the destroyer of pleasures, that is death. For verily, not a day passes upon the grave but that it cries out, saying, 'I am the house of exile, and I am the house of loneliness, and I am the house of dust, and I am the house of worms.' When a believing slave of Allah is buried, the grave says to him, 'You are most welcome. Indeed, you are the most beloved to me of all those who used to walk upon me. So now, when you have been placed in my charge and you have been brought to me, you will see my excellent treatment.'" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, "So the grave expands for him as far as the eye can see, and a door of paradise is opened for him. And when an immoral slave of Allah or an unbeliever is buried, the grave says to him, 'You are most unwelcome. Indeed, you are the most despised by me of all those who used to walk upon me. So today, as you have been placed in my charge and you have been brought to me, you will soon see my treatment towards you.'" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "The grave then closes on him until its one side meets the other and his ribs get intermingled." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then, illustrating, "Place the fingers of one hand between the fingers of the other hand," he added, "Allah sends upon him 70 serpents. If one of them were to breathe upon the earth, it would not produce any crops as long as the world remained. They will go on biting and lacerating him until he is brought forth for his account on the day of resurrection." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The grave is either a garden from among the gardens of paradise or a pit from among the pits of hell." Tirmidhi. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. سبحانك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله